Các quý vị khách quý, chúng tôi xin được phép tiếp tục chương trình hội thảo ngày hôm nay. Kính mời lên sân khấu ông Phạm Trí và ông Nguyễn Hưng, đồng sáng lập KardiaChain.
Ladies and gentlemen, we shall continue the program. Please welcome on stage Mr. Phạm Trí and Mr. Nguyễn Hưng, co-founder of KardiaChain. Warm applause.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for your time today. KardiaChain is a blockchain that aims to connect other blockchain projects that allow the transfer of assets and data on participating blockchains. The scope of our discussion today will be about blockchain interoperability, problems and solutions, also our thoughts and takes on the legal landscape and blockchain prospects. So before we go into the discussion, I would like to express my sincere gratitude and thanks to our advisors who have been the great help and our support all the way from the beginnings, including Executive Director at Goldman Sachs, Executive Director at Nomura, and with us today, there is the audience, leading technology firms, former CEO of FPT Software, Mr. Nguyễn Thanh Lâm, Chairman of MyTech, Chairman of Technimax, and last but not least, I'm very honored to have Dr. Phạm Khôi Nguyên, former Minister of Natural Resources and Environment as our advisor, Dr. Lê Sơn Hải, Deputy Minister, Chairman of Ethnic Community Affairs as our advisor. Their support, I'm deeply humbled by their support. We are a team of international and diverse with over half of our development team is from Google, US, and the other half is from leading fintech in Vietnam. So we just want to go into the problem that facing the blockchain at the moment. So blockchains, there are many blockchains in the world, but there's one inherent problem that these blockchains are not interconnected. There are many blockchains, each a design with specific needs and purpose in mind, and hence they have different pros and cons. But however, this blockchain cannot communicate it. You cannot transfer assets from one blockchain to another, and data can also be read and replicated across chain. And this leads to a problem for adoption and scalability. For us, our vision is when blockchain have mass adoption, there won't be a single blockchain that everyone use. There will be many blockchains to address different needs and different purposes. And with that, we're going into the current solution that the blockchain community is trying to addressing this problem. So if you look at this graph, so this graph, I call it trade-off and the interoperability dilemma. So as you can see, as you approach the interoperability problem, you have two you need to consider. So one is decentralized versus centralized and invasive versus non-invasive. So there's a trade-off here. So in the top left corner, I would call that the protocol-based approach. So this approach, you would have a decentralized, but however, it would be invasive. Typically, a protocol-based approach would work like this. So there would be a protocol that participating blockchain that connecting to them need to adhere by. Hence, it creates problem that existing blockchain is not compatible with this solution and it requires modification on participating chains. The second type of solution, as you see on the bottom right corner here, then this solution, it is non-invasive, but it is centralized. We would call this type of solution is watcher, connector, oracle-based approach, right? Typically, this approach only allow you to transfer access, and it tend to be quite specific use cases. So for us, our philosophy in terms of designing this solution is ideal for interoperability would be somewhere in the top right corner. It has to be a solution that is decentralized and non-invasive, and that is our design philosophy of KardiaChain. And my co-founder, Tri Pham, will go deeper into how we implement our solutions. Thank you.
So thank you. So with the knowledge of the blockchain solution at the moment, our approach in designing Cardia is to make the solution practical, scalable, and compatible. So the cornerstone of our solution we call is the dual node. The dual node have the ability to connect to two blockchain networks at the same time and have the ability to read the two lectures of the blockchain. And hence, they can read the transaction on one chain and safely ingest the update onto another chain without compromising anything. So to ensure the decentralization of the cross-chain ability of dual node, we run a two-layer BFBOS consensus between our dual node and the whole chain. So we structure KardiaChain at multiple group of dual node. So in this example, we have three different blockchain. We call it red chain, blue chain, yellow chain. So we have three different group of dual node, each supporting the connection between the external blockchain to KardiaChain. So you can notice that the number of dual node is different from each blockchain, depending on the performance and demand of the whole ecosystem. So on the left side, you can see when the transaction fee on the red chain is going up and the blue chain transaction fee going down, the network automatically adjusts and reacts to that by structure, adjust the number of dual nodes from the red chain, from the red group and the blue group to help facilitate and secure the cross-chain activity. So at the moment, we have finished our MVP, and we have implement the static DBOS consensus. We have a simple dual node that currently connects to Neo testnet and Ethereum testnet, and it is run live on those testnets now. And also, we have two demos with the cross-chain exchange and multiple-chain public voting. So looking forward, we are looking to alpha testnet at the end of this month, and next month we have the beta testnet with some major feature included. So the technology of Cardia allow many use case, but first I have the use case of interconnected DApp, which means the smart contract on different blockchain can talk, can read data and trigger event on smart contract on different chain. So in this example, a user can use their KYC data on a DApp on the red color chain and use that in a banking DApp on the blue color chain. So this process allow greatly enhance the user experience, as the user don't have to resubmit their KYC data on different blockchain all over again. And on the developer side, they don't have to waste the effort to duplicate each of the same function on different blockchain. So another use case is the cross-chain exchange, decentralized cross-chain exchange. So I will run a demo to show the to showcase the ability to transfer the data from Neo network to Ethereum network. So firstly, the user, they need to set up their account on Neo and Ethereum. And then they need to input an amount on any value they want to send from Ethereum to Neo. And then the first step, they submit the transaction to Ethereum network. And then while waiting for the Ethereum network to confirm, and the second thing happen is that the dual node on Ether Cardia will detect the transaction on Ethereum network and submit a transaction on Cardia, and then a dual node Neo Cardia will execute a request to release the Neo on Neo network. So the beauty of this demo is that all of these happen again. That means every step of the way is recorded on blockchain, on Ethereum, on Cardia. and then on Neo. So this demo is currently we are testing live on the Ethereum testnet called Rinkaby and the Neo testnet. So this demo is to showcase one of the possibility of the activity that allow to exchange any NAT5 token and ERC20 token and vice versa. But the implication of KardiaChain technology is much more, and I will get back to Hung, my co-founder, to discuss further on this.
Yes, so thank you, Chi. So for us, the way we see it is that able to exchange asset is only the first step. I think much bigger than that is that it will enable DApp and private blockchain and different blockchain able to transact data with each other. So imagine a world where different corporate, different company using different blockchain system, and now through Cardia, they can interact with each other, exchange data, and work together. I think that is a much bigger future. For us, in terms of our general thoughts on the legal landscape, we're seeing that blockchain opportunity is going to be huge. We see that there's a future where blockchain mass adoption will play a role, pivotal role in our everyday life. And there's significant prospects for blockchain to improve efficiency, both in the public and private space, especially in the data management, documentations. And clearly, I see from the legal perspective standpoint, there's a need for a regulation to safeguard consumer interests, as well as to preserve the financial stability of the system. At the same time, I think there are needs for guidelines for companies, for projects that involve in the blockchain space to innovate, at the same time to empower them at the end to add value to the society. And that concludes our presentation. Thank you very much for your time. If you have time, please drop by our booth. Thank you very much.